Hello, and welcome to the East-West Quantum Leap Symphonic Choirs. I'm David Earle, and it's my pleasure to introduce you to my favorite choir library. Made in the same fashion as the Symphonic Orchestra Library, this library features the production and oversight of Doug Rogers and Nick Phoenix, with the very special addition of Keith O. Johnson, also known as the Professor. This library was recorded with the best specialized equipment money could buy, with the best ears on the recording and the best orchestral recording technician around. It received a Gang Award, Key Buy from Keyboard Magazine, and Sound on Sound called this library breathtaking. Well, it is. Beyond simply having great samples and scripting, it revolutionized how a choir could be controlled. Using a program called Word Builder, East West finally allowed the composer to write what they wanted the choir to sing. When I first heard this, I was completely blown away and immediately started using symphonic choirs in my pieces. These choirs were recorded in amazing concert halls. They were also recorded with multiple mic positions. We have women's choirs, men's choirs, boys' choirs, and then there's these expansion packs that give you things like Voices of the Apocalypse, which are these massive cinematic choirs that are really fun to work with. Literally hundreds of people worked on this library over many, many years to bring this library to us. Let's have a listen to what it can do. Let's start with navigating the browser. In the browser, we're given two folders, instruments and multis. The instruments are sections from the choir that we can play individually. If I go to the altos, let's say, we have vowels, consonants, and effects. So this already is kind of interesting. Vowels, I would expect to be pitched. I would expect them to be able, to have it, to carry a tune. If I select one of these, you'll see that it has something called DXF or dynamic crossfade. It also has a key switch available. So when I play it normally, and I'm going to apply the key switches. So it gives us varying speeds, it gives us a staccato, it also gives us varying entrances. Some of them are right on the note, some of them have a little bit of a kind of pre-lap into the note. So that's kind of cool. When we get a consonants though, this is something that's a little bit more rare. When do you hear a choir that's saying rrr? Not very often. Let's try D. Duh. So we hear that there is a vowel attached to it, but the beginning of that note is a consonant. And that's already very interesting. When we go into non-pitched, check this out. Pretty interesting, right? Going into the alto effects, we can get things like clusters. We can get slow changes between vowels, like this one goes yo-ah. And they're all changing together, which is pretty cool, right? We even have things like shouts. And what's this one? Whisper words. Interesting stuff already just in the instruments. If I go to something like the boys choir, these can just be really beautiful to pop into the background of a piece. Already this library is sounding really good. I can go to full chorus and using the mod wheel, I'm going to move from ums to ns. So you can hear at different positions of the mod wheel, I'm getting a different consonant to start it off. When we get into the multis, this is when things get really interesting. You see how they say WB? That means we're going to be using something called Word Builder, which I'll go over in a second. If you just want to go for these instruments, they're very cool. You have things like soloists. You have Vota, which is Voices of the Apocalypse. So you can get these kind of cool, they call them angels and demons because they're intenser choir samples. But when we get into the multis, that's when things get really crazy. So if I choose, say, altos, I'm going to choose altos using dynamics with the mod wheel, and I'll replace what's here already. On the left-hand side, you see that there's more than one, just one channel. There's actually six channels that are being used to create this patch. If I go to the player is focusing on whatever channel I happen to have selected here. On the left-hand side in the player, we get our system settings, our performance scripts, we get a volume envelope for just that one channel. We get our articulation and our release articulation. So this is the choir and this is the release, separate samples. We have stereo doubling to create a spatial width, sort of a widening of the sound. We have these amazing impulse responses if we need them, which I'll talk about that in a minute. Our master output we have is stereo. We have tuning, coarse, and fine tuning. And then below that is our master output. These mic positions are very important. There are close mics, which are fairly close to the choir. You'll find that the panning is already set to sort of give us an idea of where this mic was placed when they recorded the choir. We have stage, which gives us a real beautiful sound of the stage. And then we get the surround mics, which give us really the whole hall that it was recorded in. To really make the player work, though, we need to get into Word Builder. Word Builder is pretty amazing. Essentially, what you can do is you can either load a phrase in or you can type a phrase and have the choir sing what you type. On the upper left-hand side, we're given the name of the voice and the type of voice. This is giving us a description of the voice that we're using right now. Underneath that, we have the language that we're going to type in. English, phonetics, or Votox all work. When writing in English, you can simply write in the English phrase that you want, and Word Builder will try to translate that into something that makes sense phonetically. Under phonetics, you can type phonetically in the hopes that that will come out, you know, as it should. When you choose phonetics on the right-hand side, you can see the letters that you type on the left and how they're going to sound on the right. Under Votox, we're given all of the phrases in Votox. Writing phonetically or in Votox, I find to be the most successful to give us the phrase that we want. When we look at the text editor, this is where we do all the writing. Each one of these that you see here, these letter groupings, is a syllable that's going to be sung by the choir. It looks like ha, le, lo, ya, but it's actually going to sound like hallelujah. We'll get into the text editor in just a second. On the right-hand side, we have our tools. We have an undo and a redo button. Reset position, so it takes us to the beginning of the phrase. Bypass sends the MIDI directly from Word Builder into the play engine, so it won't sing the phrase. We have a MIDI panic, an options button, and then we have the phrases that we want the choir to sing. Now I know that you're dying to see what this sounds like, so let's check it out. So as I'm playing each chord, you can hear that it's passing between all the syllables. Each time I let go, The releases all sound very natural. In the middle of the screen, we're given the word, syllable, and letter settings. If I select one of the words up here, so right now it says ha, right? I can solo just the ha part of Hallelujah. If I go to the syllable, I can change the speed of the whole syllable. If you select here, you're given some speed options. Under letter, we can select the individual letters of whatever syllable of the word we have selected by going down into the time editor and selecting each of them. The time editor is determining how the H and the A sounds, the H, A, are going to play into each other to create this sound. The time editor is really interesting. As you can see, it's broken into two parts. On the left-hand side is what's going to be playing when we hit the keys and hold them down. And on the right-hand side, we have the release. So on the left-hand side, you see this plus sign here. If I click the plus, we're given a volume graph. If I hit plus again, we're given continuous controller numbers. We'll start with just volume, and I'll choose the ah. What this is saying is that when I hit a key, it'll play the H first for this long. And then when we reach here, that's when the A starts to come in, the ah. So it's going to go ha according to this timeline. We can make adjustments to this. So I can move the whole thing if I want to. I can change its length. So I'll solo that word. What if I pull the H out? We hear a lot more of that H. Now what I can also do in the timeline is create a breakpoint and pull the volume down. So now the H is going to fade into the ah. The combination of these controls is what's going to make your choir sound realistic. There is an amazing series on YouTube that Nick Phoenix actually put together that shows how to use Word Builder really, really well. I highly suggest that you go check out the 5-part series and learn how to use this in a very, very advanced way. Up in the text editor, let's try out the text editor a little bit. I'm going to turn the word solo off, and I can delete these words using standard text commands like delete. I'm using a click and drag. And in English, I'm going to try and type something. Now you'll note that things changed color a little bit, and that's determining whether Word Builder kind of understands what I'm putting in here in English. If I switch to phonetics, it's going to show us how it looks in phonetics, and then in Votox, this is a further breakdown of how it would be written in Votox. Let's see how good it did. I'm going to reset the position. So, didn't really get it, right? This is okay. But it sounds like these, right? Let's start it over again. So that's why, even if you write it in English, it's better to go back and try to mess around with the phonetics a little bit to get exactly what you want. It takes a little bit of work, but once you get used to it, you can start writing in phonetics and Votox and get very close. So let's see what it did. If I go in here, I've got, what's D with an exclamation point? It shows us the, so that's what's giving us the, so the I, the lowercase I, what's that giving us? Let's find out. So that's I as an index. Index. So if I'm saying the, this, eh, sounds a little bit more like an E, right? So what we might do is actually blend in an eh tone. And what you can do is you can look at the phonetics and you can see, okay, well, red, so it's a lowercase e, right? Well, let's try just a lowercase e. So I'll delete that I and I'll put in a lowercase e. Reset the position. And you can hear last. That's what happened when I let go. So we have to look at some of our releases as well to get it to play well. But this is definitely sounding better. If I solo that word, I'm going this. So I might want to actually, you know, that's okay. But maybe I do want a little bit of that I index in index, right? Well, how do I do that? Well, let's go ahead and add an I back in. Now you see what happened automatically? It does this little volume crossfade thing. And what we can do is we can start to blend these two together. Solo it. So I'm going to pull this up. And it's going A-y at the end. I want to pull that volume down. And I'll pull their time back a little bit. And you see that the S is actually in the release area. I'll pull that back a little bit too. Oops, actually undo. Got to zoom a little bit so I can see what's going on. You see that little hand that comes up when you get the upper right-hand corner? It should be a little better. So it's not a little bit better. That's really how you get Word Builder to work. You know, try to type something in English, try and type something phonetically. And really, if you get into Votox, I think that that's where things start to get really, really accurate. I mean, phonetic and Votox both work really well. But blending some of these vowels together will get you something that sounds a lot more realistic than if you just leave things as is. Now, when I get into the coolest, I'll probably want to separate that word, right? Coolest, right? So I might put a space and then put an L so that I have two words. Close. Am I done? Well, let's check it out. Well, the coolest is now the coolest. So, of course, I want to go into my last, and I would turn that into a est. So here's gray, right? Maybe that would work. Let's try that out. That's Leist. Let's Try just a lowercase e. There we go. Now, of course, if you're a perfectionist, you'll go in here and you will tweak on this for a while. Remember that you can create multiple breakpoints inside these letters. So if I go into E and open this up, you create new breakpoints just by double-clicking. And you can make very complex movements between vowels, like make them go I-E-I-E-A by putting an A and an E and then having them fade back and forth between each other. It's really effective and pretty amazing. If you want to use the phrases that are built in, simply come over to Phrases and start adding them. There's a whole bunch of Latin phrases you can go with. And what's kind of neat is you can go from Angus Dei, add in a little Ve Victis, maybe add an English phrase like Saruman is coming. And you can just keep going. And if you start playing it, now, granted, a lot of times these Latin phrases do mean something, but often when you put them in the context of a piece, you're just getting sort of the feeling and the movement of the choir. You're not necessarily getting so wrapped up in exactly what they're saying. But hey, if you are, you can write it yourself. So Word Builder, symphonic choirs, absolutely stunning. And I think you're going to have a lot of fun with this. Keep in mind that the Play 5 engine still has the mixer. You can go in here and you get a full SSL channel strip, including convolution reverb and a bus compressor. If you feel like distorting your choir, go for it. There's an amp simulator and Omicide, which is a multi-band distortion unit. That's when you know, if you want to get crazy with it, you totally can. Your mic positions are also available here as well. Let's check out some of those mic positions real quick. I think they're pretty cool. I'm going to go back into the browser, and just for clarity's sake, I'm going to grab a full chorus. I'll go to the player and check out these mic selections. I'll add close. You can mix between them. Mute certain mics. Really amazing stuff. Under the Voices of the Apocalypse, you'll notice that under Multi, we have Vota Mens. Open that up. Look at all that goodness. Get back to the player, choose Word Builder. Right now they're saying Hallelujah. Well, we don't want that for Voice of the Apocalypse. We want something a little bit, you know, more ominous. Let's see. That should be pretty good. Just a couple of other details. Under letters, that's what we're moving between in our syllable, right? You can actually choose if you want them to be a normal attack, legato, staccato, or slurred. So as you go between these letters, you can actually have it slur between the letters. You can have a staccato attack. Pretty cool. When we go into syllables, so check this out. This is kind of interesting. What's this learn button all about? Well, right now when I play this, I'm going to reset the position. And when I click learn, it's going to say, do you want to change speed? and I hit start. Now I'm going to just play it, but listen to how I play it. It listened to what I just played, and now when I try to play it back, it's actually changing the timing on all of these syllables. If I go into each syllable, you can see the time change up here. So I'll undo that. Because, you know, we could always just change the length as well. Under the speed of the syllable, I can click here. And I can adjust the speed by using a percentage value as well. And that will just take the entire syllable and make it faster or slower, depending on the percentage that I pop in there. As you can see, this library is astounding. You can have a choir sing whatever you want, and you have very precise control over the phonetics of what they're going to sing. Not only that, but the choirs were amazingly recorded in fantastic spaces. When you start using this and using it well, you're going to drop jaws. I guarantee it. So I'd like to play you a demo, an example of what this library is capable of when used in the context of a song. I'll see you next time. Ciao. We'll be right back.